calcium and healthy bones and teeth. Calcium is the most abundant mineral contained in the human body. Approximately 99% of the body's calcium is in bones and teeth, and the remaining 1% is in body fluids and cells. Calcium circulates in the blood, where a constant level is maintained so that calcium is always available for use. Calcium helps support blood cell synthesis and function, clotting blood, sending and receiving nerve signals, contract and relaxing muscles. In addition, calcium is needed for heart and digestive system health. Calcium also seems to help lower blood pressure. Firstly, what calcium does? Calcium plays an essential role in maintaining our health. Calcium builds bones and maintains healthy bones. Calcium builds bones by becoming bone tissue. Calcium supports the structure and hardness of teeth and bones. Calcium helps muscles contract and relax. Calcium helps the heartbeat. Calcium helps blood clot if you are bleeding. Calcium helps blood vessels move blood throughout the body. Calcium may help control blood pressure. In addition, calcium may play a role in cardiovascular health. Calcium helps release hormones and enzymes. Calcium may help reduce the risk of colorectal and breast cancer, although the research results are limited. Secondly, how much calcium do people need? For children aged 4 to 8 years old, the recommended dietary allowances, RDA, is 1,000 mg daily, that is 1 gram of calcium daily. For children 9 to 18 years old, the RDA of calcium is 1,300 mg or 1.3 grams daily. The recommended intake for adults is 1,000 to 1,200 mg daily. Thirdly, what if you don't consume enough calcium? If you don't get enough calcium for a short time, your body gets the calcium needed from bones, decreasing bone density and causing bone loss, increasing the risk for osteoporosis or brittle bone disease. For children, not getting enough calcium may interfere with growth and increase the risk of pediatric fractures. In addition, a severe deficiency of calcium may keep children from reaching their potential adult height. Fourthly, do not consume excess amounts of calcium. Calcium can be toxic when large doses of supplements are taken. Do not overconsume calcium. The tolerable upper intake level for calcium is 2,500 mg daily. Amounts above that cause adverse effects for adults. For example, the development of calcium deposits in the kidneys causes kidney stones. Fifthly, what goods give us enough calcium? The sound sources of calcium in foods are the following. Milk and milk products, such as yogurt and most cheeses, are the best sources of calcium. Green vegetables such as kale, bok choy, broccoli are also good sources of calcium. Tofu made with calcium sulfate supplies significant amounts of calcium. Soy milk with fortified calcium is a good source of calcium. Bread, and anything made with fortified flour is a good source of calcium. One cup of milk provides about 30% calcium of the recommended dietary allowance per day for adults aged 19-50 years old. Here we want to introduce the term RDA, recommended dietary allowance. RDA is an average daily level of intake sufficient to meet the nutrient requirements of nearly all healthy people. One cup of calcium fortified soy milk provides as much as an equal amount of milk. Tofu made with calcium sulfate is an excellent source of calcium as well. A half cup of firm tofu can provide 25% of calcium of RDA. Yogurt and cheese are also good sources of calcium. Calcium fortified foods such as orange juice and cereal, dried beans and peas, some nuts such as almonds contain moderate amounts of calcium that can contribute to the calcium intake when eaten in sufficient quantities. About 30% of the calcium we eat is absorbed. We want to say that calcium from plant-based foods is less bioavailable than dairy foods. Oxalates in spinach and phytates in grains bond with some minerals, including calcium, iron, and magnesium, and partially block their absorption by the human body. This is why we need to eat various foods to maintain healthy bones and teeth.